After creating an OptoScript block in your strategy from config mode, you're ready to start programming it. From config mode, double-click the OptoScript block. This opens up the OptoScript editor. Notice these icons here. I'll make the editor window bigger. Notice how the icons change. Let's review some of the key elements of the editor. Actions. They give you access to the script version of all action commands. Conditions. Gives access to the script version of condition commands. The lock represents the strategy variables. You have access to all the variables that have already been defined. Test compile checks the syntax of the script. This area below is where you'll write your OptoScript code. It's the programming area. The output area is where you'll see the results of a test compile. Any errors are listed here. It's always best to work on the list of errors from the top down. By fixing the topmost errors, errors further down the list may get resolved. The line numbers here in the corner always tells you where your cursor is currently at. Notice your cursor coincides with what's shown here, line 1, column 1. We'll start out by adding some comments. Remember, comments are really important for you or for anyone in the future to understand what your program is doing. Since I want single line comments, I'll type 2 forward slashes and a space. They turn green, indicating it's a comment. I'll type read tank level. Then I'll hit return 3 times and add my next comment, monitor tank level. Then I'll add another comment for a delay. Let's start adding some code. The entire strategy database is available to you in OptoScript. I/O points, charts, variables, and so on. They have to have been created in pack control before you can use them in OptoScript. I'll click my cursor in this first line. We want to move the value of the analog input point, fuel level pot, to the variable fuel level reading. We're going to use built-in functionality in OptoScript. We want to enter fuel level reading equals fuel level pot semicolon. To minimize typos, let's use the insert variable tool. On the left side, we see all of the types that are available, and on the right, the names of the objects available for the types, like analog inputs or charts. In this case, we're looking for a float variable, fuel level reading. Click OK. The variable is brought into the editor. Space equals space. Notice the equal sign is blue. And now bring in the analog input point we're reading. Narrow down the search by selecting the analog input type and select fuel level pot and click OK. The variable is brought in. No possible typos because we brought it straight from the strategy's database. End the line with a semicolon. I'll press Enter to go to my next line of code, and I'll move my cursor after the next comment. Next, I want to monitor the fuel level reading and do something based on what's read. I'll use an if statement to do that. Let's take a look at some examples that you already have. We'll open up another strategy and copy some code so we can use it in our OptoScript block. Click Save in the editor, then Save in your strategy. From File, open another strategy. Navigate back to the Documents folder and scroll down to the bottom until you find your most current pack project examples. Then navigate to these folders, Pack Project, Control Basic Examples, OptoScript Examples, and then the OptoScript Examples strategy. Go ahead and open it. The chart you see has several OptoScript blocks, each with OptoScript examples. The one we're interested in is this if-then-else endif block. Double-click it and you'll see if statement examples, starting with simple ones, progressing to more complex ones. Let's copy this one here with an if-then-else example. Then hit Cancel from the editor. From the File menu, let's reopen our original strategy. Open the Fuel Monitor chart, then your OptoScript block. And put your cursor below the second comment. Paste the code. Notice how the control structures and operators are blue and values are purple. Delete some of the contents we brought over so we can tailor it for our needs. We're going to compare the fuel level reading with the fuel low limit that we set. So I'll copy the variable I previously brought in and paste it here in the parentheses. You can also copy and paste the code using the tool buttons here. I'll space. Remember, it's a good idea to add white space for readability. Then add the less than sign. Next, I'll use the variables tool to bring in the float variable, fuel level low limit. Click OK. We've set up the comparison. If the fuel level is too low, we want to set a flag to true. I'll put my cursor at the end of the line and press Enter to create a new line. Use the tab to indent. Now I'll use the Actions tool to bring in a command. The commands are divided into groups on the left and the commands or instructions on the right. Select the logical group and the set variable true command on the right and click OK. Type a left parentheses. Now bring in the integer 32 variable fuel low flag. Finish with a right parentheses and a semicolon. The else is already in place, so put your cursor below it. If the fuel level is above the low limit, then we want to set the variable to false. As a shortcut, you can copy the last statement and change the command. You can also bring it in step by step, like we did before. Finally, we need to set a delay because we're in a loop. Click Actions tool. Select the timing group and delay millisecond. Notice the Include Parameter Helps option. Check it and click OK. The command came in with parentheses and an indicator that one parameter is needed by the command. Select the text and delete it. Now use the Variables tool to bring in the Delay Medium variable. Let's look at a few more options while we're here. If you select a complete line, not a partial line, you'll see the Increase and Decrease Indent options are available. You can also set temporary bookmarks, so you can jump to different areas in the code. Remove them with this button. Bookmarks aren't saved when you close the editor. And there's also a block comment available. Use a forward slash and an asterisk next to each other, and all code thereafter turns green until you indicate the end of the comment block with an asterisk and forward slash. I'll undo the comment block by clicking the Undo tool 2 times. At this point, we've programmed the code we need to replicate the flowchart code we had programmed before. You're now ready to test compile the code.